The hurricane experts have come out with their forecast for the season that starts June 1st.
And they predict it to be more active than normal. NOAA is predicting between 13 and 19 named storms, 6 to 10 hurricanes, and 3 to 5 major hurricanes. Based on those numbers, NOAA says there's a 60% chance of an above normal hurricane season. NOAA is using that forecast as well as last year's activity to highlight why people should prepare.
These storms are a stark reminder about how vital it is to prepare for the upcoming hurricane season now, before the storms begin forming in the Atlantic Basin. The Hurricane Outlook is just one preparedness tool that citizens, forecasters, and decision makers use to get ready for what lies ahead.
The NOAA forecast was presented at the Jefferson Parish Emergency Operations Center in Gretna in commemoration of the upcoming 20th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. So why do forecasters believe this hurricane season will be more active than normal?
Our chief meteorologist, Hank Allen, is here to show us. Hank.
Yeah, I want to point out that it's, you know, not too far above normal. There's your seasonal averages from 91 to 20, the latest time all those numbers were sort of figured out here. And you can see they're within that range that NOAA's talking about and not too far off from the Colorado State range either of 9 hurricanes and 4 major hurricanes. So these are the factors that NOAA is indicating in their forecast. First off, a neutral El Nino-La Nina setup. We talk about either one of those a lot of times, and it looks like this year, neither one. And so that doesn't really hinder development like a El Nino would at times. Doesn't really super promote it like a La Nina would. So then we look at the other factors that they're talking about. Warmer than average sea surface temperatures. That one they talk about every year. It's like, when was the last time that we didn't have warmer than average sea surface temperatures? So that one a lot of times I don't even pay that much attention to. This one I think a little bit more noticeable here in terms of what we could end up seeing this year. The weak wind shear from a lot of the forecast models. Obviously, when you have a lot of wind shear, that tends to disrupt the storm development. If it does pan out where you have that weaker wind shear, it would help to promote maybe some additional development. And then this is one of the keys that they're talking about here, a higher than normal monsoon activity. A lot of those waves coming off of Africa. So this is what I want to point out about this forecast. This is encompassing the entire Atlantic Basin, the Atlantic Ocean, the Gulf, the Caribbean, all that's included. When they talk about higher monsoon activity, as we know, it's very rare for us to get storms coming off of Africa all the way over here into the northern Gulf, into southeast Louisiana and southern Mississippi. So part of that higher than average forecast doesn't, to me, really impact us because we don't typically get impacted by a couple of these factors that's causing the forecast, if that makes sense, guys. So obviously we'll see activity in the Gulf. We'll have to deal with storms close by at some point. But I just think this is one of those seasons where, you know, they're highlighting more of the Atlantic Ocean development and the East Coast of the U.S. as opposed to the Gulf, at least the factors that, you know, influence those storms.
The big picture explanation is certainly appreciated.
Yeah.
Thanks, Hank.
Well, next week, be sure to watch our half-hour special, Hurricane Season 2025, Your Questions Answered. Hank Allen, Kerrigan Chauvin, and Natalie Parsons will explore the topics you need to know about Friday, May 30th at 6:30 on WGNO, and Saturday, May 31st at 9 p.m. on NOAA 38.